Praise the Lord. I hope y'all enjoyed my little video of me fishing. You know, I had the GoPro camera strapped to my chest. So I wanted to send a word to y'all, you know, to send some encouragement. You know, something I learned, you know, while I'm out there fishing, I love to go fishing. You know, I love to go fishing, not just fishing for fish, but I like to go fishing for souls too as well. You know, before the Lord called me out of the world, you know, and he anointed me, I used to do a lot of fishing, you know, like many other disciples in the Bible. But I wanted to send an encouraging word, you know, something that I've learned, you know, with these past couple of days that I've been fishing and fellowshipping. You know, while I'm out there fishing takes a lot of patience. You know, it was times where within a few hours when we got to our destination to fish, I wouldn't catch anything, you know. I wouldn't even get a bite on my line at all, you know, but I wouldn't let it frustrate me. But I'm going to be honest, there were times I started getting a little frustrated, you know, but I had to continuously be patient. I had to wait, you know. I couldn't just make the fish bite my line, you know. So after I gained a little patience, you know, I started getting bites, you know. They started biting the bait on my fishing line. But then when I go to try to jerk it, I would miss the fish. I would miss the catch, you know, and that happened a few times. And I started getting frustrated even more, you know. So I learned that I got to be more patient. And I had a brother with me, you know, he was coaching me, you know, on what I was doing wrong. He was telling me the things that I was doing wrong. And, you know, at first I was like, man, I've been fishing for a while, you know, ever since I was a youngin'. I know what I'm doing. But then, you know, when he started showing me, pointing out the things that I was doing wrong, I heeded to his counsel. You know, so when I heeded to his counsel, I tell you the truth, I started catching them back to back, left and right, you know, and but I also had to be patient while I listened to his counsel too. You know, see, what I was doing wrong was when I would jerk after I got a bite, when I would jerk, I would quickly start reeling it, and I wasn't setting my hook. And that's why I was feeling it. So the brother pointed out what I was doing wrong. He pointed out how I need to set my hook first and then start reeling. Because see, I was so quick to want, I had got grown exhausted. I was exhausted of waiting just to get a bite. So when I did get a bite on the fishing hook, I would quickly jerk it and start reeling. I wouldn't set my hook first. So I was yanking the hook out of the fish's mouth because I was yanking it and reeling in quickly instead of setting the hook. So anyway, once I heeded to his counsel and I gained more patience, you know, I started catching them left and right. And I learned something in this. You know, I learned that that's how we gotta be when it comes to this walk with Jesus Christ. You know, God will place people in our path to give us counsel, to so we can learn, so we can grow, so we can mature, because we are all the body of Christ, you know. And it gets to the point sometimes where we get to knowing so much word, we get to knowing so much that we feel like can't nobody tell us anything, and we feel like we can't learn more. But I'm here to tell you, that's pride, my friend. And it's always somebody who has experienced some things that we haven't experienced in our lives, and God will send them in our path so we can learn from them, so that we can heed to that counsel. But that's what I learned in this process, you know, while I was fishing. You know, when I heeded to his counsel, I started catching them left and right, you know, and I rejoiced in the fact. And that's how we got to be with one another. You know, we got to be willing to heed counsel from one another. We got to be willing to listen to one another instead of getting lifted up in pride, thinking that we know everything, you know, and also patience. I learned that we got to be patient, not just with one another, but we got to be patient with the Lord. Sometimes we want to rush the Lord, you know, when we're going through some things in our lives, when we praying for something. Sometimes when we praying, we rushing God. We want God to do it when we want him to do it. But we are on God's time. And the Bible says, you know, that under the, in the book of Ecclesiastes, it says, to everything under heaven, there is a purpose. There is a season for everything. It's a time for everything under the heaven. And we got to understand that we are on the Lord's timing. We cannot rush him when we're going through things. ways in our lives when we are in need of things. You know, we can't rush God because God is the beginning and the end. All time abides in the hands of the Lord. So we got to be patient. The Psalms say, the Bible say in the book of Psalms, to wait patiently on the Lord. Wait, I say, on the Lord. And that's what we got to do. And that's what I learned too when I was fishing, you know. And I got to thinking about Peter. You know, the Bible says when Jesus Christ went to Peter and them, you know, Peter and them, they had just got done fishing all night long. They had just got done, but they didn't catch anything. But when Jesus Christ stepped on the scene, he said, hey, go out into the deep and cast your nets over there and you will catch some fish. And Peter was like, Lord, I've been doing this all night. I know what I'm doing. I'm a fisherman by trade. But he said, nevertheless, at thy word, O Lord, I will do it. And when he obeyed the Lord and he cast what God, what Jesus told him to cast, that they got a multitude, large multitude of fish, so much so that they had to call another boat to come and help them. And you know, I had learned from that, you know, and while you out fishing, you will learn a lot. It takes a lot of patience, you know, and I feel like God has made me patient a lot more than I have been. I feel like God has really put patience inside of my heart, because it's something that I've been praying for. Lord, I want to be more patient in my life, Lord God. Lord, I want to be more patient, and I feel like God used this fishing to do it to me, you know, and I'm just grateful for it. But I just wanted to share this experience with y'all. I wanted to share this to encourage some people out there, and also to tell you, we got to listen to one another. We got to heed to that counsel. Don't get to the point where you think you know every single thing, because it's something that God will show somebody else. It's some type of revelation God will show somebody else that he haven't showed you, and he'll use them to try to tell you. But if you refuse it, like Jesus said, they that reject you, they rejecting me. You might be rejecting the Lord because you don't want to heed to that counsel. So I'm here to tell you, we don't know everything. We still got a lot to learn, but it's important that we have patience in this walk with the Lord, and we wait on the Lord, because the Lord will renew our strength. So maybe you've been praying, my friend, and you feel like God is tarrying. You feel like he ain't answering. But I'm here to tell you to wait on the Lord. Ask God to give you patience, you know, because when we have patience and we wait on the Lord, God will honor that. Just like when I was fishing, you know, I was like, man, I ain't catching nothing. Man, I keep missing these fish. But then when God was making me more patient than what I was, you know. I ain't want to just pack up and leave, you know, without catching a fish. So I was becoming more and more patient as the hours was going by. And when I was patient and I heeded to the counsel of my brother, then God blessed me to start catching fish left and right. So I just wanted to share this with y'all. Y'all be blessed.